Once you have n8n installed, you're then ready to start using your instance to develop new workflows and automations. Before we get to that though, here's a quick overview of what you will find inside of your instance. When you first log in, you will find this welcome screen. And at the top here, you have three different tabs with workflows, credentials, and executions. Workflows is where all of the workflows that you will build will be stored. Credentials is where you can store things like API keys or tokens to connect the services that you want to use with n8n, and I'll share an example for this with you in just a little bit. And under the executions tab here, you will find it stores all of the executions that you have run, just in case you want to see what's worked and debug anything that hasn't worked. On the left-hand side here, you will find that you've got a tab called templates. And if you click onto this, it'll take you off to the n8n website where you can search through, in this case, 1,085 different workflow templates that have already been built and you can import into your n8n instance. The one we'll take a look at today, we're going to build from scratch. Variables down here is only available on the enterprise plan, so we're going to leave that one for now. And the other options that you've got here is the settings part of the account where you can flip through all of these. Now, most of these, again, are only available on the enterprise plan. So again, we're just going to leave those now for the time being. So let's have a look then at how we build a really simple workflow in n8n. So to prepare for this, I've put together just a real simple type form. And I've also built myself a real simple table in Airtable. My table has first name, last name, and email address, and my form that I've created is also going to ask for the same three bits of information. Before I get to filling that in, let's have a look at how we connect those two things together in n8n. So firstly, I'm going to build myself a new workflow. If you have just logged in, you're going to find that you've got this start from scratch button, but you can also click the create button anywhere here or here to create a new workflow. So we're going to start this from scratch. Now, to make any one of these workflows work, we need some form of trigger event. Trigger events come in lots of different forms. To have a look at those, we're going to click onto this square here where it says add first step. And these are the different options that we've got. So we can trigger it manually, which basically means that we can run the workflow from clicking on a button inside of the workflow. This really only works if you want to run these things manually, but in our case, we want these things to run automatically. You can run them on an app event. Now what this means is, in our case here, you can see it mentions things like Telegram, Notion, or Airtable. n8n can connect to multiple different pieces of software where you don't need to send anything such as a webhook or anything like that. Once you've logged in, it collects the data from that service and pulls it into your instance. You can run on a schedule. So for example, you can set this thing up to run automatically every hour, 30 minutes, 5 days, etc., etc., etc. Or you can run it on a webhook call, and we'll talk about webhook calls in a later video. Other things such as on a form submission, when called by another workflow, and on a chat message, these are all more complex things that are out of scope of this video, but I will cover those later in another video for you. But for now, we're going to connect our typeform and Airtable together. So my trigger event, I'm going to use an app event. So if I click onto this, it'll now give you this entire list of all of these different services that n8n has pre-built connections for. I've built mine with typeform, so I'm going to search for typeform in this list. And we can see here that we have a typeform trigger. So I'm going to click onto this and it'll bring in my typeform trigger node. And now I need to set the parameters to make this work. So firstly, I need to provide a credential to connect with. And we do that by clicking on the credential drop-down menu. And when I do this, you're going to find that I don't have any credentials just now for a type form. So I'm going to need to create a new one. And when I click on this, I get two different options of access token and OAuth2. To keep this nice and simple, I'm going to use the access token option. To get this, I need to go to my Typeform account. And by clicking on my initials up in the top left hand corner here and clicking onto account settings, I get this menu here and I need to generate what is known here as a personal token. So I'm going to click on to create a new token. I'm going to give it a name. So I'm just going to call this test n8n for the sake of this. You can choose to have this work with all scopes, which means you're going to give it full access to your, in this case, Typeform instance. Or you can control the scopes that you want it to connect to if you are more security conscious. In some cases, n8n will tell you in the credentials window which scopes you need access to. In this case, it's not doing that. So to make this easy, I'm just going to give it access to all scopes and then click on to generate token. This then gives me my personal access token. So I'm going to copy this, bring it back to my n8n instance, and I'm going to paste it in this window here and click on to save. And you can see here that the connection has tested successfully, which means that my instance is now connected to my Typeform account. So I can close this down. Now once I've done that, it'll pull in all of the data from Typeform. So I can hit this drop-down menu where it says form name or ID. And I have this form which is called my new form. So this is the one which I want to connect this node to. Can click onto that. And in this case, that is pretty much it. And to see how this works, the thing I'm going to do now is to run this test step option. So if I click onto this, n8n now goes into a state of listening for this test event. So I'm going to head off now to my type form, and I have it here. So I'm just going to pop in my details. I'm just going to call myself admin. My last name is going to be test. And my email address, I'm just going to put demo@test.com. And when I submit this and go back to my n8n instance, I can now see the screen's changed and it's pulled in the data that I've just submitted. It means the test has worked. And we can now begin to use that data. So I'm just going to click out of this now to go back to the canvas. So we can see this is now all green, which means that this has worked. And I now want to connect this to my Airtable that I built a little bit earlier too. So to do that, I'm going to click onto the plus sign to the right of the Typeform node. Now this isn't a trigger in this case, because we already have the trigger event. Now all of the nodes that we add into n8n from this point will all be connections. So I'm going to search for Airtable in the list here. I know that Airtable has a pre-designed integration. So I'm going to click onto this. And in my case, I want to create a new record. Similar to before, we need to create credentials. So I don't have Airtable credentials. So I'm going to create a new credential. I already have set this one up, so I'm going to paste in my access token. In this case, you can see that n8n is telling us the scopes that we need in order for this to work. So once all of that is in, I'm going to click on to save. And now we can see that the connection has all worked. We can close that down. Once that's all complete, I can then start to fill in the rest of the details in the node. As we're now connected to Airtable, we can just fill in the information that's already here, ready for us in the node. So in my case, my resource is going to be a record, and I want to create a record. The base here is from Airtable. I can just click onto the Choose menu, and I have this base called n8n test, and the table that I want to update is table 1. This here, my first name, last name, and email address is currently empty. Once we're in that position, it's now got this stage here where it's asking for the values to send. And this is the first name, last name, and email address from my Airtable that I just shared with you. And I want to pull the data from my type form into my Airtable instance. So to the left of this here, we can see we've got my type form trigger. This is the data that came in the previous node. What's your first name? What's your last name? What's your email address? And to get those things into my Airtable instance, I just need to grab a hold by hovering over and clicking onto the information and dragging it into the field. So in this case, it's first name, then last name, and then email address. When it goes green, as it has here, this does suggest that everything is looking good and is ready to go. You can also click onto this little arrow in the bottom right-hand corner to make that larger if you wanted to see what it was looking like. So the left-hand side here is what is known as an expression. This is the n8n way of representing your data. And on the right-hand side, the result is what it will send. In my case, this is right, it is admin. So I'm going to close this down. And then I'm going to test my step. The output now has given me an ID, create a time and fields, which suggests that this has worked. And if I go back to my Airtable and just give this one quick second, you can now see that that entry has now appeared in my Airtable. Excellent. From there, we can just keep building off to the right of this. So you can use any inputted and outputted data in a future node. So for example, if I wanted to then send an email, I can click onto the add node to the right. I can search for, let's say, SMTP or send email. I'm not going to connect this to any credentials. I'm just going to use this as an example for the purpose of this video. But essentially what I can now do is in the left-hand side, I've now got my typeform trigger node, and I've also got my Airtable response here. So I can, in fact, drag over the email address from the typeform trigger. It's going to put that into the two. And I can also use the information from the Airtable or any previous triggers or nodes that are in my n8n instance. And in most cases, you can bring in any of those details into any of the windows too. So I'm going to say here, hi, space, first name. Let's pull it from Airtable. Pop that to the right here and tidy that up a little bit. That's going to now say, hi, admin. Thanks for your submission. Your reference is, and let's use the Airtable ID, entry ID for that. And we could pop that into the end of there as well. And again, if I just make that larger, you can see the email that was sent here would be, hi admin, thanks for your submission, your reference is, etc., etc. And if that node was connected, then that would send that email to that email address. And that's pretty much it for building workflows. You can, if you need to, add on additional nodes, for example. I'm going to fill this one in, but I can disconnect it from here. And I can connect it this way as well, which means that those two things here, the send email and the HTTP request, would run at the same time. Essentially, and then I can pull in as many of these that I want to. Just put another HTTP request in there just for the sake of this. Pull that into the middle, and those two things would connect together. This makes it look a bit more complex, and you may run into some issues which we'll deal with in future videos too, around what happens if you were to do this. Linear flows work beautifully. Sometimes when you break off the branches, you may well run into some problems. Once we're happy with all of that, we can click on to save. And then in order for this to work all by itself, we need to make it active. So we just click the inactive slider at the top of the screen here to active. sorry, this won't work because I have issues with these nodes. Just get rid of those. Active. And basically, this now means that we are ready to start using this flow. And every time somebody fills in that type form, it will then connect to my Airtable. If it won't allow you to activate it and you see some warnings like what I had just there, it does mean that you have an issue that needs to be resolved in one of the nodes. It'll go red and it'll show you a red triangle with an exclamation mark. So you'll need to go back and resolve that issue before you can make this active. In future videos, we'll have a look at how to connect lots of these different applications and use webhook triggers, all kinds of other stuff that makes real simple workflows and some incredibly complex ones. But for now, that's just a real basic overview of how n8n works. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel, and I look forward to seeing you in a future video soon. Thanks again.